Ain't No Half Steppin' with Marcus J. Thank y'all everybody for staying with us to be down with the discussion tonight. Hit us up in social media on one of our Facebook pages, or hit us up in MixLR. Hit us up by calling us by phone to 804-402-2893. Be down at the flagship show of LegacyInternetRadio.com. We appreciate the love and the support that we get from everybody from week after week. If it wasn't for y'all listening, we wouldn't be in here talking. All right, let's get one of the comments that we got back in here from Hakeem. Hakeem is asking about the 91-year-old. We're going to talk about that here in a minute. Get your comment in. That's why he wants to know how you know that Fat Albert's real name was Albert Michael. Did you watch that corny movie with Keenan in it? Is that how you found out? He wants to know how you know that's his real name.
No, I just binged it.
Like in Bing, like Google Junior.
Yes, but you get rewarded for binging.
For binging, you do get some rewards for binging. So I could dig it. Ain't no hashtag with Marcus J. All right, I'm ready to gross everybody out. Y'all ready to be grossed out? Yes, everybody ready to be grossed out? Yes, you ready to be grossed out? All right, before I even say anything, I'm gonna go ahead and gross everybody out. I'm grossing y'all out. All right, now this article, and I caught some flack when I was home in Jersey this weekend because you know I talked about this, and I made some comments which I'll share as we kind of flesh out the discussion here. But meet the 31-year-old Kyle Jones and his 91-year-old girlfriend. Since his teenage years, Kyle says he's been attracted to much older women. Quote, "The first time I realized I was into older women, I was probably 12 or 13, he told the Daily Mail. "It's funny, the things that they are self-conscious about, I'm into. I like lines. I'm into the neck feature. Women worry about their boob sagging. I think the natural hang looks great. Everybody's brain is wired differently," Kyle continued. "Some guys prefer blondes. Some prefer brunettes. Some, like other guys, like old ladies." Interestingly, Kyle's mother, 50-year-old Cecilia Jones, says she realized her son had a thing for older women very early on, though he's not looking to settle down anytime soon. He has been carrying on a long-term casual relationship. Now, let me just say this. Whenever people say casual relationship, that means they're doing it. That's exactly what that means. Casual relationship with 91-year-old Marjorie McCool for the past 5 years. He even brought her home to meet his mother. When I first met Kyle, I was quite thrilled. "It's very flattering to have a younger guy chase you," Marjorie said. "He was very nice." "He was very nice. I sometimes feel he's another son. Till we hop in the bed, then I feel different." End quote. Speaking of their bedroom rendezvous, the great-grandmother felt the need to go into a bit of detail about them, saying, quote, "The physical side of our relationship is wonderful. I amaze myself. He amazes me," she gushed. "There's nothing better. I wear sexy outfits to bed. I try to keep my bra on, though, because I don't have much left." And for the fact that Kyle frequently sees other women, Marjorie says she doesn't sweat that anymore. Quote, "In the beginning, I got jealous of his other women, but he keeps coming back to me and tells me I'm the best. Perhaps I would like to meet the right person and settle down, but I know they would die before me," said Kyle. I'm sorry. I'm almost finished. All right. "Though her sons are much older than Kyle, at 71, 63, 61, 52, and 50, Marjorie says they don't meddle too much in her relationship because it's her business. But while the couple may not receive much criticism from family members, they admit that others have had quite a bit to say about their relationship. Quote, "When people see us together, they probably think that he's my son or maybe a grandson. I have grandsons older. The most common criticism I hear is you're after money, you're after inheritance," as Kyle. "I hear that all the time, and it's not true. I do because I like, and they like it too. Not something you see every day, but hey, look, to each his own." That's the end of the article. And I tell you, I'll be honest with you, I haven't seen a room full of quiet women in a very long time. That ain't something that you're going to see very often. Certainly not here at Legacy Internet Radio with the strong will sisters that we got. And right here on Ain't No Half Step with Marcus J. So I am going to attack my co-host first. Because I want your opinion, so I'm going to need you to grab the mic and take your hand off your mouth and go ahead and tell me what you think about it, because I see the disturbed, disgusted, and just downright black blown away look on your face, but I'm gonna take you to task. I need some comments here. So that's why, what you got?
I'm about to throw up from two places. How nasty. How can it get?
What's the name of those beds that bend up in different ways? Like you could put the legs up. So she's probably very like surprised.
Craftmatic bed.
Is that what it is? Craftmatic? Tempur-Pedic, yeah. Or whatever. Yeah. Whatever ones bend up so that you can put your knees by your shoulders. Maybe she's been doing that for a while and that's.
You know, guys, really, I only had like a slight headache. Now I feel nauseous.
It's pretty bad.
She's surprised at herself that she could get her feet up that high. I don't know. I just.
You know what's it's great.
She's got that good.
You know, and I had some questions. I'll be honest with you. Like, I had some questions that will come off as crass, but I really, honestly, I don't mean them to be. But I'm gonna let the ladies, you know, blast jump in here. What's your thoughts?
She got the Fountain of Youth down there.
So it's not the Fountain of Youth anymore, honey.
Be dry as a powder.
It is not the Fountain of Youth.
Well, that actually, you know, since you brought it up, that actually was what my question
is. It's like
is, because, you know,
full of lube.
I mean, yeah, it's a whole lot of KY going on.
Puke.
Yeah, it's a lot of KY. Hakeem says he's heard some funny and crazy things on this show, but this right here,
what's the
I don't know that this one can be topped. All that with the sex is great, and she had to wear a bra to bed. It's tripping him out.
What's the dog that has all the layers over his face?
A hound dog. Are you talking about
the Sharpei? So you know he's got to be kind of like moving some of the sag skin
out of the
and
way.
She wears sexy
outfits.
Sexy on a 91
she wears sexy outfits to bed, but she got to keep her bra on she don't have much left.
She's wearing what pink is that? Bloomers.
What is it that men look when you're bent over? What is that position when they're looking at your
doggy style?
No, but it's called something when they're looking at how you look when you bend over from the back. It's not doggy style. They're looking at your something.
Okay, well,
I don't know.
But I wonder.
You're a lot more sexy savvy than I am. Because I
really, y'all, that's making me so nauseous.
Oh my
god, I am so gross. Like I'm physically like.
All right, so let me just tell y'all. Let me tell y'all a conversation how this came up, because everybody knows me personally knows I was with my family in New Jersey this weekend, and this came up, and we were talking, and it was, you know, a lot of female family members, you know, that were much older than, some of them were in their 40s, but most of them were in their 70s that we were having this discussion with. You know, I talked to my mom about this and everything, and my mother actually said it would be glad that it's not his grandmother. Other than that, that while it's, you know, a little bit disturbing, and so be it. I made the comment that a 91 year old man don't want to be with a 91 year old woman, and these ladies jumped on me so bad, like I was the worst person. So I need to know if I was tripping, Tony, when I said that a 91 year old dude doesn't want a 91 year old lady unless his name is Kyle Jones.
No, it's true. I mean, I don't even think most men want to be with like a 51 year old lady. Like that's when they like revert to the 25 year old and
unless her
hit,
name
like,
is Angela
middle
Bassett.
Age. I mean, they do. It's like, you know, in a few years I'll be like obsolete because I'll be too old. I think just men in general like to see that youthful, like shapely, you know, contoured, you know, woman's body.
Well,
but
at 91 you're not, so don't.
Hakeem is asking if the word bless you're looking for is ogling or oogling. Is that the word?
No. When the woman bends over in front so her butt is cocked up, it's called looking at her spread. That's what I was thinking.
That's what you were looking
yes.
for.
So I was wondering
so
what her spread.
He's checking her ass.
But hers is probably just a hang. It's probably not a spread.
Her butt.
No, but
falls.
Thank you,
Hans.
There's no muscle in her butt.
Yeah,
there is
like,
no spread.
Everything is hang.
It's like happy face over happy face over happy face over happy face.
I'm showing that. I'm showing. No, she ain't.
Her liver spots are so beautiful.
Oh, my stomach hurts.
The only thing that I can think about when I'm looking at this picture is like a turkey. She looks like a turkey.
I'm jealous. I must say, when I get 91, I hope some little 31. No, I don't.
No,
what am I gonna do with it?
It's a lot of work.
Ask her. You better ask her now because she's about ready to expire.
She's the best. At what?
What
can you do at 91?
My toes are earlier. She got no teeth now. So you just lift her head, let it go, let it drop back down.
And gurgle a little bit. Lift her head, gurgle.
I just want everybody to know that men do not have the market cornered on innuendo and crassness. I'm just glad that I'm not the one that has to make these jokes. It's them, like, and I'm loving it.
He's like, are you okay? She says yes. He let her head go.
But you know what, though? I'm gonna tell you what's not sexy about this. Like, when you're doing your business, you know, and you go to sleep and whatnot, and then like constantly having to check her pulse like every single time to make sure that she's not dead.
Does she take her teeth out at night?
Smells like old lady.
Yeah, but that's what he likes. The whole point is that's what he likes.
Well. I have a hypothesis.
Like, you ever like hug the old lady at church and feel grossed out just off of hugging her?
Cause you know they trying to get a feel now. The old dudes. I got to do the deacon hug from the side. You can't hug straight up.
Oh my God.
But I'm getting a little bit off here. But I have a hypothesis, and it's this: that guys tend to like where their mindset is, especially when that middle age kicks in and they're still mentally 30 something, 25 something in their mind, so that's why they are attracted to that age. Girl. R. Kelly, he's probably that age, so that's what he likes. I mean, my hypothesis, but we'll get back to that.
I guess I'm somewhere in the neighborhood of 28 to 53 then, for me personally. I'm somewhere in that range.
Like, my grandmother was 91 when she passed away. And I cannot imagine a 31-year-old dude coming in the house talking about, what's up, boo? Like, we would have fought him. Like,
come here, baby. Let me put this on.
What's up?
Hey, bae.
How do you holler at a 91-year-old?
Mr. LP Steven Sykes of Enliven Radio. You can hear him every single Tuesday from 7 to 9. He says his grandmother is active at 81, but that she doesn't date anyone 5 years above or under. But he's saying that there's some sort of mental issue going on with this guy. You know, I don't begrudge anybody the opportunity to have love. You know, my grandmother left us, you know, in 2003 at the age of 82. You know, she had a friend. You know, and but Charlie was an old man. Charlie was older than she was.
You're usually thinking of a companion in a nursing home. They sitting there holding hands together while they sitting on the bench, not getting ready to play their nursing home.
Well, and I think too, maybe it's easier for him to be with these older women because, one, you know, there's not gonna be a lot of drama. They ain't gonna be fighting and all that stuff.
Listen, I don't.
But two, maybe he ain't nobody fighting. Hey,
look, ain't nobody fighting him for her.
Yeah, he got that one.
A woman. Like, his age would be like, if you don't get around here with that little, but with those old women, they're like, he's the man.
I don't feel it anyway.
So it may be just to boost him up as a man, because that's really all that will accept him.
I honestly disagree with that because of what the article said. I think when we talk about how he said that he had had this attraction to old women since he was like 12 or 13 years old, and his mother confirms that, I just think the dude is wired different, and we can laugh and have fun with it, and I'm going to laugh and have fun with it. But you know, Mr. LP alluded to there being some sort of mental illness. I don't know that I would say that he's ill. I just think that his likes are different. You got some people that only date a certain kind of, you know, women. You got some black dudes that only date white women. You got some black dudes that only date black women. I mean, how you're wired is what you want.
But at 12, old is 30,
right? He just like having Sunday dinner. She makes him
soft food because everything got to be soft.
Hey, look, you get the right.
She chews it up and she gives it to him.
you get the right one. You can get all of that. That's nasty. Ain't no house to have
groceries in the house. All of your groceries.
He gonna make groceries. Remember, we down south. Make groceries. Grandma, what is that? Groceries. Then we say make groceries. That's make like groceries. A down south thing. Cause make groceries.
There's
like,
no such thing as making.
There's no groceries. Such thing
I
as
make groceries every time I go to the grocery.
There's no such thing.
Dumbest phrase I ever heard in my life. Make groceries.
I make groceries.
No, I've heard someone say they're gonna change their check. Why don't you just say I'm going to cash my
change
check?
Change
their
check.
Changing it from a check to money. So they're all changing right. It.
Make groceries and changing checks. That's some down south stuff.
And wine the window.
She was West Indian.
Wine the what?
Wine the window down.
What the hell does that mean?
Wine the window down. I wine my window.
No, what
wind
is that?
A window down.
That's when you had
the manual window. Oh, yeah. Wind it down. Oh, yeah. I got the little button. I ain't had to wind a window down in 20 years.
Everybody ain't got it like that. Yeah, I know.
I just got Carl Bougie on you just now.
I need a cracker. I'm nauseous.
Oh, my goodness. Okay.
I'm seriously. That's just gross. Yeah.
She is literally eating a cracker right now. Oh my God!
My nephew used to say,
one day we will be that old, and we would hope to have.
And you know what? When I'm that old, I'll take it that old because it's about all I'm gonna get. But while I'm not that old, I'm telling y'all now, I don't want to see it when your boys, when the twins get longer than the father.
Got it.
I don't want to see it
when the twins get longer than the father.
When the twins are older, I don't want to.
Okay, I'm just glad I'm not the one that's having to make the jokes tonight.
She's keeping up.
She's got the bed and she's got the things hanging from the ceiling.
She's got the bed with the little railing thing that she put on. How you put your kids up? So she got the bed around. So she's trying to hold on to the bed.
She proud of us, Mark.
I'm loving it. Hey, Sed is checking in just now when I said down south. He wants to know why I got to be down south stuff. Cause y'all say the dumb shit.
Don't nobody say nothing.
Don't nobody say make groceries up in Jersey.
But y'all say what's up, son.
Yeah.
Done, son.
Yeah, there's symbolism to that.
Done, son.
There's symbolism to son.
She said, we say that.
What is done? What is done?
That's what they say in Queens.
What is done? You're not telling me what done is.
All it is, all of them is just changing the symbol.
Done,
but that, changing the word. But that,
they say done.
Done. That's what they say in Queens. But not just Queens, in Queensbridge, and one little piece of the project, and one little borough.
Give me an example.
Can nobody tell me?
What's going on, done?
You said son, not done.
It's both. It's both.
They say both of them.
What's up, done?
Yes.
Never heard of it. Never heard of some dumb goy. It's a fool.
You know what?
We say, what's up, son? Yes.
Yeah, but I'm answering your question. All it is the cats and queens just changed the word. That's all that is.
So why can't we say make groceries?
No, that was just
because done is dumb, just as dumb as making groceries.
It's not.
It is dumb. It is.
I'd rather you say what's up, son, than say I'm going to make.
Yeah, man, I agree. All right, let's move on. Ain't no half stepping with Marcus J. Next story I want to get into is about a woman. I'm getting this one from News1.com. This one's about a woman who got basically booted from school for wearing her religious hair wear. Delisha Barnett is a young woman enrolled at Proway Hair School when she refused to remove her religious hair wear and not conform to their requested standards. She claimed school officials scoffed and decided to not allow her to attend classes. Now, the Muslim woman is upset that the Stone Mountain, Georgia school reportedly violated her rights to manifest her religion along with her rights to an education. Now, Barnett and the DeKalb Southern Christian Leadership Conference, for those who don't know, that was founded, of course, by Martin Luther King. They have teamed to defend her religious rights. Barnett, who wears a religious hijab that has, since the World Trade Center in 9/11 tragedy, taken on a negative connotation even when worn by Black women, the terrorist stereotype of Arabs have been thrust upon women who wear hijabs, and in many instances they have even been attacked for wearing them in public. Therefore, Black women who are Muslims reportedly have to face both racism for being Black and a Muslim who wears a hijab. The SCLC represent Barnett held a press conference last week saying that Barnett was notified of her termination from Proway School via a letter that offered no valid reason for her dismissal. According to the civil rights organization, the school violated her constitutional rights and they are backing her battle with the school. The protest against the alleged discriminatory act was held outside the school when the news station tried to contact the school. Officials reportedly refused to offer their side of the story. All right, bless you up. What you got?
So, again, Noah, number one, I'm confused. The Southern Christian Leadership Conference is trying to back up a Muslim, but whatever.
But we could talk about that, too.
Well,
SCLC, you know, they're a civil rights organization founded by Martin Luther King. And the reason why it's called Southern Leaders Christians Conference is because they are Christian people. But as a civil rights organization, they will protect the civil rights of whomever. I know instances of National Action Network, which is the group that's headed by Al Sharpton, that has stood up for white folk, gay people. You know, so if it's a civil rights issue if they doing what they supposed to do.
Thank you for schooling me.
They on it. Yep.
Well, number one, most of the time, beauticians usually keep their hair tight. You know, you can't really see what her hair looks like under hijab. So that's number one. Number two, it's a school. You can go to another school. Number three, if the letter didn't express exactly why they let her go, how can you say that it was because of that? Maybe she burned somebody's hair off. You don't know.
It's very possible. And it must be a reason why she is confident. Maybe some sort of confrontation that she may have had, some sort of discussion. A lot of times what I like to do is bring up these instances to talk about the greater issue, the greater situation. And the thing that I wanted to talk about here is the hijab, because I've seen this happen before. You know what I mean? Like, you know, these people, you know, in these places who are unused to or uncomfortable with seeing anything that is connected to Islam or Muslim or what have you, most notably being a hijab, a woman, of course, unfortunately being an easier target, because they do wear something that is easily or easier to target. Oftentimes with a Muslim man, there's not a lot of ways. A lot of them grow beards and things like that. But other than that, you just don't know. So Tony, jump in here. What's your thoughts?
Yeah, I mean, you know, unfortunately, people are kind of ignorant and just kind of mix it all together, you know, and it doesn't just happen with the females. You see it too with men. For example, Sikh men wear the wrap and people think, oh, they're, you know, they're Middle Eastern, they're terrorists, but it's, you know, totally different religious affiliation. So it's just a matter of ignorance. And, you know, if it's not impeding her ability to do her job or service customers or, you know, learn whatever she's learned, if it's not a deterrent to other students in the school, which it shouldn't be, she should be allowed to wear it. You know, we have religious freedoms. But again, you know, yeah, she could just go to another school, but why shouldn't she be able to attend the school that she wants to go to just because of her religious beliefs and her having this the hijab on?
I look at it like this. I mean, we have gotten comfortable with citing any kind of difference that a person has as a reason to be disrespectful to them. It used to be the color of your skin. In a lot of ways, it still is the color of your skin. It used to be your gender. In a lot of ways, it still is your gender. But one of the things, particularly as the article alluded to, that we do, particularly since 1990, I believe the first bombing was in 93. So since 93 and on to 2001, up through the present, you know, it's easier to cite, you know, Islam and Muslim people as the reason why we have all of these problems. So at any time you feel that it's okay, not you, you know, but I'm saying in general, we feel that it's okay to attack the things that they do. I've had conversations with intelligent people, people who I know that's smarter than the things that they're saying, who will look you square in the eye and tell you, you know, that Islam is a terrible religion and all the people are terrorists and
Timothy
all of this kind
McVeigh
of
was white,
Timothy
so.
McVeigh was, you know, Nichols was white. Most of these people, the people that shot up the Las Vegas cops yesterday were white. You know, I mean, John Allen Muhammad, even though his name was Muhammad, you know, that, well, I'm talking about the DC sniper.
Oh, okay.
You know, I mean, he had a Muslim name. He converted. You know, he wasn't born and raised a Muslim. He was a black dude, you know, from wherever he was from. You know, my point is, a lot of this mass craziness that you got going on here on American soil, there are American bred, in many cases, white American terrorists. And these, you know, I don't want to make them out to be the only ones that are, you know, pushing this negative stereotype, because there's some of us black folk that do it too. We feed it. I've had conversations with smart people, people I know that are smart, that will argue with you that terrorists are Muslim, you know, and they forget that the Ku Klux Klan was based in, you know, Christianity. And these are the same people who were stringing up people, you know, if you was black, you had to go up in that tree. If you was Jewish, you had to go up in that tree. You know what I'm saying? So that just it upsets me whenever I see that. Ain't no high stepping. With Marcus J. All right, let us move on. This next one is sad. This one is about some person here in New York City. I believe he was in Brooklyn, New York. He was released from prison, I believe sometime in late May. And he was out on the street for a couple of weeks, a 27-year-old man. He's been charged in the death of 6-year-old Prince Joshua Avito and the near-fatal stabbing of his friend, 7-year-old Michaela Caples. They were just a couple of kids who happened to come across this guy. He was at large for a while, and they finally caught him. I didn't really want to bring up this story to talk that much about this story. What I wanted to bring it up was to talk about mental illness, because I found myself debating this with people today. Daniel St. Hubert, a paranoid schizophrenic, he spent 5 years in the slammer for trying to strangle his mother with an electrical cord. And he got out of jail, and now we'd see what ended up happening. And Tony, I know that we're going to be losing you here in a minute, so I want to get your opinion on this one first before you have to leave us. I am on record as saying that you being sick, as long as you're not hurting nobody, can be a us problem. Once you start hurting people, particularly stabbing little babies, it officially becomes a you problem, and you get to go to jail, not hospital. To that you say what?
There are varying levels of mental illness. And you know, most of us know that paranoid schizophrenia is one of the most severe, because people become totally detached from reality. So, you know, maybe somebody who has schizophrenia, you may look at their punishment or their actions different from someone who just suffers from, say, depression. Because you know, with depression, they're usually you're more aware and more conscious of your actions and the consequences of your actions. So I don't think you can lump mental illness into one, you know, category and say, well, just because they have mental illness, then if they do something, they should be placed in a mental hospital. I think you have to look at the degree of their illness and also the crimes that they do, that they commit. And evaluate each individual separately. You know, just because he's been diagnosed as a schizophrenic, was he taking his meds and, you know, was, you know, sober and conscious when he decided to hurt those children?
Right.
Or was he just totally gone when this incident took place? I think it has to go deeper than just looking at him saying he's got mental illness, throw him in jail or put him in a hospital. You got to look at each one individually.
What they are saying is police, they suspect that he may have killed an 18-year-old college student and critically injured a 53-year-old homeless man. And I guess I want to clarify what my position is on this. I understand mental illness. I respect mental illness. Someone that's a paranoid schizophrenic who has not committed any crimes that include the death of children. You know, I certainly understand, you know, treating them and trying to help them get well. And if there's medication that can be had for them, then great. Let's make sure that they get it. As a taxpayer, I would not have a problem including that in whatever other stuff that our taxes pay for with regards to illness, whether it be mental or physical. But where you lose me in every instance is, while I understand there is a thing called mental illness, I am not interested in giving anyone a pass under any circumstances, even knowing how sick this man is, that I get to put him in a hospital for his life. If it's a prison hospital, okay, cool. But you don't get to go to, you know, hospital jail. You don't get to go to just the hospital. Like, to me, there needs to be some punishment here. I understand that you were detached. You killed a little boy. I'm sorry. You killed a little boy. And you being sick and bringing that shit to my life is a you problem, and that you just made it a me problem. And you need to be punished for that. I feel strongly on that one. Bless, jump in here. Tell me what you think.
Well, I've seen the lady that goes to jail, you know, like every week she's done something that makes her have to go to jail. And or maybe, let me say, she'll be away for like 3 months and she'll come back from jail and she'll be all happy and walking down the street and, hi baby, how you doing today? And everything's good and she's just so nice and calm. And then about that third week, She hasn't had her meds, and she's gone. She's mooning people that drive by. She's breaking windows. She's standing outside harassing people at the liquor store. So, I mean, I see that. I see where jail, well, at least jail doesn't help anything. They gave her meds for a little while, but there's nothing that's going to constantly keep her at that level where she should be. As far as, yes, if it's a mental hospital that is also a jail, like I think it was Southside, there used to be one off of Crater Road down in Petersburg. I don't know if they still do that, but I think they house prisoners that have mental illness. If they stay in there and they cannot, I don't see where jail would help them. Other than
treatment in jail?
They do sometimes, but I don't know for sure, but a lot of times the corrections officers don't make sure that you have your medicine. A lot of times people in jail,
that's an in-house problem, and it should be corrected. You know, they do have a period where you come and you get your meds, and you know they need to make sure they take it, and you know that's something that they need to address in-house. But somebody needs to be responsible for the death. Saying I'm crazy and locking me up in Creedmoor does not help me.
If I read correctly, his mother said that, you know, he should have gone to a mental hospital, and she was the one that he attacked the first before he killed these kids.
Yeah, there's a couple of people who said that he should have been in a mental hospital, and as I was doing this story earlier, I you know, was blogging with a couple people, and I had been taken to task again for, you know, my position being somewhat aggressive about this. Hakeem is checking in. He says that he agrees with me 100% on this one, word for word, by the way. Dating Pooh Diva checked in. She said that the schizophrenia is serious mental illness. Many people don't understand the ramifications of having it. It's caused by chemical imbalance in the brain. People with schizophrenia experience paranoia, hallucinations, etc. Perfectly nice, upstanding person could develop the illness and harm people without even knowing what's going on with them. And she continues on, with that being said, I would say the person needed to have mental service 5 years prior and probably would not have harmed anyone. With medication and therapy, he may have been able to function in society, or in worst case scenario, he would have been placed in a facility to prevent the kind of situation from happening. While I understand that and I respect that, I still stand firm on, you know, I want to do what I can do to help you, you know, as far as a taxpayer. But once you start killing people, I'm no longer interested in thinking about trying to help you. I know you're sick, but you being sick is a you problem that you just made a me problem because you killed my 7-year-old. You know what I mean? Like, you killed my 53-year-old granddad. You know what I mean? Like, no, I'm not. I don't care that you're sick anymore.
What's the man's name whose son tried to get, I think he tried to stab him or tried to kill him, and his son passed.
You talking about Creed Deeds here locally? Yeah, mm-hmm. Yeah. And that situation was sad. Creed Deeds is a local Virginia politician. And what's sad about that was there, and I don't know the specifics on the timing, but they called the hospital, and the hospital was supposed to keep him for a certain amount of time, mm-hmm. and they didn't keep him for that amount of time or something like that. And then it was during that time that he ended up being home, and the confrontation took place with Creed Deeds and his son, and he stabbed up Creed Deeds pretty good, tried to kill him, his father, mm-hmm. And it, you know, Creed Deeds survived, but I think the son ended up killing himself.
Yeah, he did.
Mm-hmm. You know, so, you know, I'm not saying that mental illness is not real. I know it's real. I've seen, you know, what they used to call manic depressive. They don't call it that anymore. They call it bipolar disorder. Schizophrenia, I get it. I know it. I know all of that stuff is real. Depression, mental illness, it's real. I get it. But when you kill somebody, all bets are off for me.
I mean, they had to search for him. That's one thing. I mean, it's like he wasn't anywhere he could be found. You know, they had to go out and look for him for a little while.
So what does that tell you?
Yeah, so something tells mm-hmm. he knew to go and hide. He mm-hmm. did something wrong. So, mm-hmm. I don't know. Or maybe it was just the knowing that he tried to do something to his mother. I got put away. So I just did something to someone. I'm going to get put away. Let me
Cell block six, baby.
It is what it is. Ain't no half step on Marcus. The last thing I want to get into in this segment. Did y'all see the story last week? The video with this crazy ass white woman screaming.
Oh yes,
at this brother outside of a store in Chicatagua, New York. Apparently, he started his car and startled her children, and that was enough for her to just completely snap. And he starts filming her. And now, who knows what happened before this video started? But this woman was saying some of the most nasty, vile things that you could ever say to a person, you know, using in front of her children, using the N-word and things of that sort. And I'm going to have my words on this. I'm going to close out the segment with my words on this. That's why I want you up first. You've seen the video, or at least have heard about it. What's your thoughts on it?
I've seen the video.
Okay, what's your thoughts?
You know, for those who've seen the video, you can tell this lady has a problem. I believe she has a problem. She can be mad all she wants to, and yes, she does have hate. She's full of hate. And whatever her problem is, she took it out on this guy. Maybe her, I don't, like Marcus said, you know, who knows what happened before the video. He starts his car coming from the store, and depending on what kind of car he was driving, maybe it has some kind of engine, the muffler made this noise, the kids jumped, I don't know. But she is full of freaking rage, and she was nasty. I thought she needed to be slapped really, really well. And I would have sat in that car, and I'm really happy. I'm very, very happy, I have to say, at the way he managed her. I'm very happy at the way he managed her, because most of us would have jumped up. We would have got violent, and you would have been the one in trouble, not her. So I'm very, very happy at the way he handled her. Now, throwing that coffee, if she wanted to throw her coffee, soda, or whatever it was she had in her hand, I would have challenged her ass on that, and I would have tore it up. But I'm glad at the way she handled it. I think she has a problem. I listened to her after interview. She has a problem.
She tried to play the "I got black family members" card too.
Oh, every racist plays that card. And you know what, y'all? Let me just say, if you're secretly listening, put the card back in the deck. It's over. We're not trying to hear it.
I would much prefer you, as a white person, call me an N-word to my face and mean it, than call me an N-word to my face and then later say, you know, Marcus made me mad. Uh-huh. I got black friends. He's just an asshole. You know what I mean?
My cousin is black.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry for your cousin.
Yeah, to be related
to
you.
Bless,
what's your thoughts on it?
She claimed that, and from what I'm imagining, when he started the cam, he had, like, his music was loud at first. He turned it down.
He was playing Nas, too.
The world is out.
He was playing Nas, yeah.
But, and from what I'm imagining, the way that the height of where he was, it was probably a big truck, like a Caddy or something like that.
SUV or something.
It may have been souped up. Mm-hmm. As they were walking by in front to go into the Family Dollar, maybe the little boy was running ahead where he shouldn't have been. And when it started,
he got started.
Was probably it. Because the way the kids were acting,
the little rugrats were all over the place.
But you know what's sad about that? Bless, you brought up a good point, when you said that she was doing all of this in front of her children. And when she said to him, you know, I don't like black people.
And he doesn't like black people.
And she said, the boy, he doesn't like black people either. And, you know, that to me was the part that was more sad than anything. Because as a grown person, you reserve the right to be stupid. But as a grown person, you do not reserve the right to teach your stupid to the youth, even if that youth is your youth. And that's sad to me.
Did she not say, do you know how many cops I stripped for?
Yeah, she did.
I missed that part.
She said that, and she also said, I'm going to call my husband. And she gets on the phone with him, and he's going to come up here. And then you heard the little kid, you know, like, yeah, dad's coming. Like that's supposed to affect me.
Listening, dad wasn't even trying to have it. Dad was not, you know.
Why are you talking to him? Why is he taping you?
Yeah, you know, I don't think dad was really trying to have it.
I just think that, you know, again, if we are going to attach mental illness, you know, your mental illness is a you problem. Mm-hmm. You don't get to infiltrate my life with your mental illness and expect me to be okay with it. I'm sorry. If that sounds insensitive, then so be it. It's just insensitive. You know, it's one of those things where, you know, we can work to try to get you help. I'm okay with that. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm okay with it coming out of my tax dollars. I'm okay with that. I am okay because I respect the fact that, You know, if you can develop something like diabetes, then you can affect, then you can develop something like mental illness. You know what I mean? Like if your body does not work the way that other people's bodies work in a normal way, then you can have some problems. I can dig it, you know, but your diabetes ain't gonna cause my child to die. You know what I mean? So, you know, my sensitivity level is a little bit lower for something like that than it would be for, you know, that kind of ailment. And if that's what this lady is dealing with, then so be it. But
I agree with you. It needs to be managed.
You use the word rage. Like, this woman had the kind of rage that was frightening. Like, she was scary. She really was. Like, she didn't scare him sitting there in that car, because he knew if he really had to, he could put her down, which would have been the worst possible thing that he could have done. But he could have done it if she began to attack him. But I think another smart thing he did, Bless, was not get out of that car.
Yep.
He never got out of the car, because that would have been seen as an act of aggression on his part, which may have opened her up to attack him. And once she did that, then who knows what may have happened. Because we know when domestic violence happens, chances are, regardless of who the aggressor is, the dude is probably the one that's going to go away. You know, and let's keep it real. We're talking about a black dude and a white lady, and it's a fight, and it's a public fight. And
why would there more people out front of the Family Dollar? That's a weird Family Dollar. I've never seen. I saw one person.
I mean, you know, they were going in and out. Looks like they, you know, like, you know, you just see her in this video, her and a little girl and a little boy,
and they playing in front of the door.
You know, they're like playing and stuff. But you know, I just think the whole thing is sad, because we live in a world where, you know, people know what to say to try to hurt you. And that's the reason why I get so upset with black people who want to use this word. I was in the barbershop, I think I told the story last week, and I had a guy who I know is a smart guy, because I heard him debate about other stuff as I've gone to this barbershop over the 20 plus years I've been going there. And he gave a dissertation about why it's okay for black people to use the N-word. And I ended up saying it to him at the end of it. I was like, that's the dumbest thing I ever heard in my life. And I know it came off as disrespectful. I didn't mean it that way. But that's the way it came off, because it was the dumbest thing I ever heard. And if you ever, ever have any kind of pause as to whether it's okay for us to use that word, look at the rage in this woman's eyes and look at how she was trying to hurt him with that word.
Well, I was going to say, I noticed, I went to the gym the other day, and there was he may have been white, he may have been Hispanic. He was listening to a whole bunch of different music, and I didn't know why, because he had it turned all the way up, and I could hear it while I was sitting in the sauna. And it went from the Spanish music, it went to Jay-Z, it went to some other song where I kept hearing nigger. So I'm sorry, y'all don't say the N-word, I'm sorry, please don't find me, don't. But the word was said in the song. And I sat there and I thought for a second, I'm like, okay, well, he's not black as far as I could tell. But if I listen to this type of music enough, I can see where I would feel like it's okay for me to say this.
Yeah.
It's okay, because I hear it in rap music. I could talk to my friends like this. Oh, but I gotta make sure ain't no black people around when I say it. You know, it sometimes that little trigger right there might cut off, and he'll forget, and somebody
and say something.
And next thing you know,
I'll tell you how I know they know better. I'm gonna tell you how I know they know better. One of my favorite rappers of all time, somebody who I think, in my opinion, is probably top three wordsmith. Not top three rapper, but certainly top three wordsmith, is Eminem. I don't think that I've heard, maybe Redman might be a very close second, in my opinion, to Eminem. Eminem, I think, is probably the best wordsmith that I've ever heard. And I've listened to every single record because I've purchased them, because I like him. I ain't never heard him use that word. Never. Never. And I know where he grew up. He grew up in 8 Mile, which is all black neighborhood. And I've never, that's not to say he's never used it. I'm just saying that I have never heard him use that word, which tells me that they know better. They know better. Even the ones we think don't know better know better. The older ones.
Let me say, the older ones, the younger ones coming up now, they don't. I was having a conversation with somebody. Oh, it was you. I think we were somewhere and we were having a conversation how they did not know that N-word was a derogatory for Negro. And So some of the youth don't even know. And they might get messed up one day hanging around people and the older person catch them saying it and it's over.
Yeah, I mean, The sad thing is, you're right, it's upbringing, it's teaching, and we have failed. We failed. Black people have failed. Our generation before us has failed. There's always been black people using this word. You can go all the way back to slavery. You know, you watch Roots and you saw how they talk to each other and all of that kind of stuff. So it's always been out there. You know what I'm saying? But once you know better, you're supposed to do better. And that apparently was some sort of disconnect from the 60s generation through the 70s generation up through the present. I don't want to be a big hypocrite here. I used to use the word. And to this day, in the interest of full disclosure, I catch myself to this day to keep from saying it because it was something that I grew up saying. Mm-hmm. So there are times when instinctively it even wants to come out of my mouth, even though I'm like the N-word police. But I'm cognizant. I'm aware. I want to do better when it comes to this. Mm-hmm. And I'll drop an F-bomb, you know, with 50 trailers behind it. F-bomb. Y'all hear how easy I say the S-word. Mm-hmm. But that word I won't say. And I feel strongly about that because I don't like any slurs. I don't want to hear slurs for Jewish people. I don't want to hear slurs for Spanish people. I don't want to hear slurs for gay people. It's just something that I'm, you know, I figure if I'm going to be that way with the N-word, then I'm going to be consistent. And mm-hmm. that's the reason why I'm like that. Ain't no half-stepping. With Marcus J, we are going to take another break. And when we come back, SY has been screaming and screaming and screaming for weeks for us to do some random. You want to do some random?
Oh, yes.
She wants to do random, so we're going
to
do
it. She needs to wake up.
She's going
to
do some random. We're going to do some random. So when we come back, that's what we're going to do. I got SY and I got Blessed. We lost Tony, but we got SY and Blessed and yours truly, Marcus J. Ain't no half step and be back in a minute.